If remission rates are high in AML, why are many patients not cured?
So relapse being the main reason that outcomes in AML are so dismal. And for patients that get chemotherapy alone, the majority will end up relapsing at some point. And for patients that get a bone marrow transplant, it's even gotten to the point now where patients with AML who get in remission and get a bone marrow transplant, the most likely thing in the long run that ends up causing treatment failure is relapse. And so it used to be, going back 10 or 20 years ago, that for patients that had a bone marrow transplant, the most worrisome thing was the side effects of the bone marrow transplant. And so patients would die from graft versus host disease or infections, which are sort of the most common side effects of bone marrow transplant. Nowadays, we see less of that, and it's gotten to the point now we have better and better ways of doing bone marrow transplant and better medicines for controlling graft versus host disease and better treatments for infections. And so it's now gotten to the point that actually having your leukemia come back after a transplant is the most dangerous thing for anyone that's had a transplant. And so that's one of the things we're particularly interested in here is what can we do after someone has had a bone marrow transplant to try to prevent their leukemia from coming back? And there are some patients, and this is where the next generation sequencing or gene mutation testing becomes really important, because there are some patients that have these targetable gene mutations where they can take a pill that targets their leukemia. And we think that by doing that after a bone marrow transplant, we can have great effect on preventing their leukemia from coming back.
Thanks for watching. By creating a HealthTree account, you can get exclusive access to the latest HealthTree University content, track your course progress, take notes, and bookmark lessons. Visit the links in the description below to get started.